all the time, all the time, all the time, all the time. God is good.
Hi guys, welcome to another Motivation Monday. I'm so excited to be here with you. So it's a little bit late, so it's a Motivation Wednesday. But I just wanted to, you guys are probably looking around me like, this isn't her usual space. Well, like, where are all the pillows? I actually got the opportunity to move. So I'm currently now in T-Dot, like in Toronto, which is amazing, but also the reason why this video is very late. I couldn't really figure out where to put the video and what to do, but I'm so here. So a little bit about this. I would show you guys the place, but it's not quite ready, but stay tuned for a home video, a home decor video, I guess. But yeah, I just wanted to talk a little bit about this home. It's a home that was only because God made a way, and it's just an answer to a promise that he gave me a long time ago. So Luke 1:45, blessed is she who believes that God will fulfill all the promises he has given to her. So if you guys are believing for huge things, I'm sitting in a miracle, so I'm just believing alongside you that God will fulfill his promises to you. So I told you a few weeks ago that I have two pastors. So two pastors have already dedicated this home, but I just want to do a quick prayer and just like dedicate this home to God. So Lord God, I just thank you so much for giving me this space, giving me provision to have this space, oh God. And Lord, I just thank you. And I just pray that this place will be glorifying to you, and that I will know it's only because of your will and your way and nothing that I've done, oh God. So God, I dedicate this home back to you. Do as you will, God. And let me just be a servant, and let this just be a vessel for you to do what you want to do, Lord Jesus. Thank you. So guys, we're going to go into a little bit about, so this is going to be a quick word because I'm a little late for school, but I really wanted to talk to you guys about, you know, yes, last week we talked about good people to keep in your circle, and this week we're going to talk about people who need to stay a little bit away. So Isaiah 2:22 says, humans are as frail as breath. Don't place your trust in them. So last week I talked about good people who can feed you, but I also need you to understand that people just like you and me are flawed. All of us are flawed human beings. All of us have done things to people that we wish we had never done before. Even the greatest people have hurt people, and hurt people hurt people. So I just wanted to remind you that even though we have, God tells us to fellowship with people and tells us to bring people into the Word of God and keep them close, that we still have to understand that they're humans. We can't put them on a pedestal. We can't put them on a place where we would put God. And that's been a really big, hard thing for me, because I have this tendency of meeting great people and being like, they're so great, they're so amazing, and putting them on pedestals just for them to fall, which is inevitable. But it isn't their fault, it's my fault, because I'm placing people in a place where only God can be. So just remember, y'all, people, even though people are great, even though we look up to people and you do need mentorship, you do need friendship, just remember that people are frail and that you can't just put them on a pedestal. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't be friends with people because they don't meet your requirements. It just means you gotta be a little bit more aware that, like, the people cannot fulfill the same place that God does. Like, they will not love you like on the level that God does. So Psalms 26:4-5 says, sorry, so David says in Psalms 26:4-5, I do not sit with the deceitful, nor do I associate with hypocrites. I abhor the assembly of evildoers and refuse to sit with the wicked. Yo, if you're deceitful, if you're a hypocrite, if you're an evildoer, if you're wicked, you are not in my circle. You can't be in my circle. You can't be in my energy. You can't be in my space. Because all of those people are against the Word of God. All of those people will not push you closer to God. And I think for me, just kind of learning who God wants in my circle and who he doesn't, who his word says for me to keep in my circle and who he says to depart from or to love from a distance, is very key. So a huge thing for me is integrity. So in that verse it says deceitful people. And for me, if I don't trust that you will say what you can do, if I can't trust that you will do what you said you would do, or that you'll be the person that you explain to me or act that you are to me, I can't trust you to be my inner circle, you know? I can't trust that you will like have my best back, like have my back the way I have your back. And so it's really a really big thing is like to stay away from people who start showing deceitful tendencies and show lack of integrity. That's a really huge thing for me. Another thing in the verse says like wicked and evil doers. You cannot surround yourself with people who like get pleasure or get drive from doing evil things like gossiping, like stealing, any of that, like, or like, I don't know, some girls, you know, be doing some things, some boys be doing some things, like just surrounding yourself with people like that, because I know that there's a verse, yes. 1 Corinthians 15:33, do not be misled, bad company corrupts good character. Y'all, have you not seen it? That girl, that guy that your friend with is dating this other girl, this other guy, and the second they start dating, your friend starts acting some type of way, like not acting like themselves. This is what bad company does. It also happens with friendships. I've seen it so many times in friendships when there was somebody who like really wanted to lead a good life, but they had just friends from different groups that weren't doing the same things. And it's honestly, we all like, oh, I can bring my friend or I can bring my boyfriend to this. Like, no, bad company corrupts good character. It just is what happens. So just being able to surround yourself with people who will encourage you in the way of God and like just be good people. I know that's sometimes really hard because you're like, oh, my friends are really good people. They just have this one little thing. And that one little thing is okay because everyone has a little thing. Everyone has something. But if it's evil, if it's wicked, if it's deceitful, those are the people you need to be like staying away from. Another big thing for me that I realized is you cannot be friends with people who do not encourage your purpose in God, who do not cheer you on, who are not your biggest cheerleaders. Like, no, that was the hugest lesson I learned continuously. Like, if you cannot be friends, like, I have a friend who's in med school in Saskatoon. She knows who she is. She's not even Christian, but she tells me that she watches my videos because sometimes she misses me and wants to hear my voice. I have another family friend who I haven't spoken for a while. She was the first person to subscribe to my page, the first person to follow, the first person to blog. Like, I know it's not about YouTube, but I will remember my day ones. But it's about the fact that there are people in your lives who will support your purpose. And because I have had, I always talk about like bad friends. I've had some amazing friends, some ride or die friends. And those friends have taught me about the love of God and the friendships that God wants for me. And makes the bad friends look real bad. Like real like, we just can't hang no more because I got some good friends, you know? So I just want you guys to understand that like God will bring people into your life who are there for your purpose, who want you to succeed, who want you to follow the plans that he has for your life. And if your friends cannot do that, they're just gonna have to step to the side for this season. And I just wanna remind you guys that I'm not saying do not be friends with these people at all, but I'm saying for the season that God is taking you into, you can't just have anybody in your clique. You need to be selective, you need to pray for discernment, and just like, keep riding hard. So I'm gonna pray real quick for you guys about friendships. So dear God, I just wanna thank you for just how great you are and how mighty you are, and that you have friendships for us that are discernible, that lead us closer to you, God. And we don't want to be friends with people that you don't want us to be friends with. We don't want people in our clique, in our circle, that do not rep you harder than we do, or rep us harder and bring us closer to you, God. So we just pray this week that you will come into our experiences, come into our lives, and change our friendships, change our minds, and just bring us closer to people that you want us to be close to. So guys, I just want you guys to know that I'm thinking about you, loving on you, praying for you. I want you guys to subscribe, to like this video, to share with everyone you know, and to keep up to date. I will try to be filming on Mondays. I will try to do a home tour next week, but things are kind of crazy still. But just want you guys to know, have an amazing week. Bye, love you guys. Mwah.